Hey guys, welcome to this video. In this video I am going to discuss about different data types in C++ language. We will discuss most commonly used data types in C++ language. Let's get started. First of all, int data type is used to store integer like 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3 and so on. Int data type occupies 4 bytes of memory. Next is float data type. Float data type is used to store the numbers with decimal point like 4.5, 4.6. It also occupies 4 bytes of memory. Next is double. Double data type occupies 8 bytes of memory. It is also used to store real values with decimal points like 4.5, 4.6, 4.3. The difference between float and double is that float data type occupies 4 bytes of memory and the double data type occupies 8 bytes of memory. Both of these can be used to store a floating point number like 4.5, 4.3, the number with decimal points. But integer data type used to store only integer variables, integer values like 0, plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3 and so on. Next is character data type. Character data type is used to store single character like A, we can store A, B, C. Single character can be stored in character data type. It occupies 1 bytes of memory. Next is bool. Bool data type is used for true and false. Boolean variable can hold a value true or false. It also occupies a 1 bytes of memory. We can also check the size of data types on our compiler like so. Cout is used to display the output on the console. I will be discussing about C in Cout in later videos, but today you should simply keep in mind that it is used to display the output on the console. Size of int is size of in parentheses int. Bytes. And L is used to start a new line. This is used so that control will go to the next line. The output will be shown after this statement. Either we write the statement this same line, but the result is shown on the next line in the console window. Cout is used to display the output on the console, and this is the syntax of cout statement. In double quotes we write size of int is. Anything written in double quotes will be printed same as on the console window. Size of int is, it will be printed like so on the console window. Anything written in double quotes will be printed similarly as we have written here. Size of int, it will show the size of integer data type. and then this operator bytes. This is also written in double quotes. It will be printed same in the on the console window. Then endl is used to end the line and start new line. Our output will be shown on the next line. Similarly, we can also check the size of other data types, like so size of float is equal, and in parentheses we can write float. Similarly, size of character double here we can also let double is similarly we can check the size of bool. In parentheses we will also write bool because we want to check the size of bool data type. And on the next line, system I write this so that our console window stays open and we can clearly see our output. If I do not write this statement system pass, the console will vanish in few seconds and we will not be able to see our output clearly. So now let's save our program, control plus s and debug our program. As you can see, the size of int is 4 bytes, size of float is 4 bytes, size of double is 8 bytes, size of bool is 1 byte. Similarly, we can check the size of any data type like so. Now see, shout is used to display the output on the console. This is our console. So the anything written in double quotes is printed same on the console as it is written in the double quotes. So you can see size of int is and colon is printed same in the console window. Then size of int, it will return the size of int data type. So what is the size of int data type? It returns 4. Then bytes, we also written it in double quotes, so it will be printed same on the console window. So it is printed. Then this operator endl is used to end the this line and start a new line. If I did not write endl, then all the outputs will be on the console window will be on the same line. For example, if I do not write this endl, then size of int is 4 byte, after that size of float is 4 byte, size of double is, it will be printed in same line. So I put endl at the last of each statement, each line, so that it will show on the next line. We can also use slash n instead of endl to end a new line. So similarly, cout is used to show the output on the console window, and the size of float, because it is written in double quotes, anything written in double quotes will be printed same on the console window. So it is similarly printed on the console window. Then size of float will return the size of float data type. So what is the float size of float data type? It returns 4. So the size of float data type is 4. Then bytes is also written in double quotes, so it will 4 will be bytes will be printed similarly. and then we are ending the this line and starting a new line so that our output show on the next line. So these are the most commonly used data types in C++ languages, and we can check the size of these data types like so using the code. Okay guys, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Allah Hafiz.